This girl is not Dora, but she is an explorer and wants to reach this treasure. However, currently she can't jump that far, so let's make this platform move. The main idea is that we define two waypoints and the platform will move between those, but I'll also show you how we can define multiple waypoints. By the way, we have a character who has a dynamic rigid body 2D component and a capsule collider attached. Okay, so first create a parent object called moving platform and make our steel platform as a child of it. Also create another child where we'll define the waypoints. We'll have two of them for now. Move the first one here and the other one to the other side. Let's add a script to the platform and call it moving platform. Here we need three members. The waypoints, which will be an array of transforms, the platform speed so we can configure how fast we want to go, and we also need to know which is the next waypoint we want to visit, so let's store an index for that. Create a move platform method. Here let's find out which is the current destination by taking the current waypoint index element out of the waypoints array. Then move the platform towards this point by using the moveTowards function, which returns the new position. The current position is the transform.position, the target is the target, and the max distance is the maximum distance the platform can traverse since the previous frame, so multiply the speed by time.deltaTime. Lastly, we need to check if we reach the current waypoint, so if the distance is lower than a very small value, we can say we reached it. Instead of the distance, we should use SQR magnitude, which returns the square of the distance, so it will be much cheaper since it doesn't use the square root operation. If we reach the destination, we move to the next waypoint, so current waypoint index, plus 1. But after we reach the last one, we should continue with the first one, so we can simply divide that by the number of waypoints and get the remainder. So this will be 0, then 1, then 2, but 2 by 2 is 1 and the remainder is 0, so it's 0, 1, 0 and so on. In the update method, we just call the movePlatform method. Set the speed and waypoints in the inspector, and look, it's moving. One problem, if we jump on the platform, the character won't move along with it, so we should fix this with a little trick. First add another box collider 2D to the platform, which is a trigger and is used for detecting when the player jumps on it. Make it a little bit smaller horizontally than the platform itself, so if the player jumps on the edge of the platform, she will fall down. Let's create the onTriggerEnter2D function. If the player goes into this area, we will set her parent to the current game object. In this way, she will move along with the platform. Create the onTriggerExit2D function in the same way, but if the player leaves this area, we have to unparent her, so set the parent to null. That means she will no longer move with the platform, and we'll have no parent, like here, in the beginning. And now everything works just fine. But what if we have another treasure right here? Firstly, that's really great news. Secondly, we need another waypoint. So create one more, place it around here, and add it to the array. We can also make the platform stop for a moment after we reach the waypoint. First, create a new member called waitTime and another one which stores if the platform is currently waiting. Modify the movePlatform method, so if we reach the waypoint, we set the isWaiting variable to true, and then start a coroutine, which first waits a little bit and then sets back the isWaiting variable to false. In the update method, check if we should move, and move only when we should. And it's done! Now she can open both chests in one go. Oh no! Our second chest! It's broken! Yeah, she jumped to watch another platformer tutorial from me, so should you. Check out the playlist on the screen right now.